there, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Kika, and oh boy, I have missed you guys. This is the first video in a knitting video series that I'm launching here on my YouTube channel. And for those of you who don't know me, my name is Kika, and actually knitwithkika, which is the name of all my channels, so on here and on Instagram, actually means knitting Kika. Kutava means knitting in Finnish, and it's kind of funny because in the past few years I've really been focusing on photography. I've shared lots of photography tips here on my YouTube channel, and over on Instagram you'll find lots of my photos, and I do sort of creative photography, even though that's like a super broad term. But it all started with knitting. 4 or 5 years ago, I had a little knitwear shop, and then I made the name knitwithkika, and now I feel like the circle is coming to an end. No, coming to a loop. Well, you know what I mean, that saying. And I'm sort of going back to my roots, which feels so, so good, and I'm so, so excited to finally do this, like a proper knitting video series here on my YouTube channel. I would love to hear more about your, can you say, relationship to knitting. So are you a beginner? Have you knitted something before? Are you excited to start this knitting challenge with me? So let me know in the comments below. Yeah, just what your knitting status is. Before we dive into it, this summer, I kind of allowed myself to take a bit of a break. I did this huge masterclass in the spring, and then I worked on it all summer, which was called the Self-Taught Self-Employed Masterclass, and that really took the juice out of me. I was pretty tired and pretty empty after it. So then I've just taken some time. I've spent it here out in our summer place, out here in Finland, in the archipelago, and I just found this new spark for knitting, and I went back to one of my dearest hobbies. I'm a very passionate knitter. I've always knitted, but I've never, for some reason, shared so much about it here on YouTube or on social media. But now something just clicked, and it feels like it's the time. So I'm not quite sure yet what shape this is gonna take, but this is essentially, I'm gonna be teaching you, even if you've never knitted before, from the basics, the beginners, all the way up to how to knit your own sweaters and cardigans and lace and cables and knitting in the round and all that good stuff. But we're gonna take it one step at a time with one video per week. Every week there's going to be a new project, and then of course as we go it's gonna get more advanced, and I'll share lots of tips and inspiration, hopefully, to you. All the tips that I've gathered in the past, probably 25 years plus of being a knitter and knitting lots and lots. I did one video where I tried on all the knitwear that I haven't sold or given away, so you can check that out here if you want to see some of the knits that I've made. Oh yeah, and one thing, I would absolutely love to see your creations or what you knit. So we have a hashtag called knitwithkika. Kind of simple, but I thought, why make it too overly complicated? So knitwithkika, so please use that hashtag and tag me if you share some of the things you knit over here on YouTube or then on Instagram, so that we can come and see it and we can create this nice little cozy knitting community. I for sure would think that would be so nice for the upcoming winter, just to see what we create, and then we can get inspired by each other and ideas. And yeah, also in the comments, let me know just if you're excited to start this with me. All right, without further ado, let me show you what we're gonna make today. So I am going to be teaching you how to cast on, how to knit stitch, and then how to cast off. And we're going to make a dishcloth in what is called garter stitch. So this is just when you knit, just the like the basic knit stitch. And I think this is a really nice project to start with because, well, first of all, it's not too big, so it's not so overwhelming. So you can complete this is, well, almost in an evening, but maybe if you've never knitted before, maybe 2 evenings or a few tries. And I think this just is really nice to have because it's sustainable and you can put it in the dishwasher, and it will just make your kitchen so much prettier to have these handmade dishcloths instead of the ones that you get from the supermarket. So what you need for this project is some knitting needles. Now, there are different types of knitting needles out there. These are the most regular ones, or the normal knitting needles that I'm sure you've seen. And they come in different sizes. So usually on the needles, it will say what size they are. And I live in Europe, so it says in millimeters. So they range from, I think the smallest are 2 millimeters to 10 millimeters, or even up to 20 millimeters, 35 millimeters, like these huge ones. But that's the one that you want to be looking for. In the US, it's a little bit different. So I'll put a size chart right here on the screen for you so you can see the corresponding size. Then you also have these circular knitting needles. So this is for when you knit in the round, and also when you have bigger project, you can use these type of needles. And then you also have double pointed needles, which are used when you knit, for example, socks. But more about that later. Then also you can get the knitting needles in different materials. So I prefer wooden needles always, just because then your stitches won't slide off as easily. And bamboo is something that a lot of knitters really like. You can also get them in steel or I think plastic, but I prefer wooden needles. So I would definitely recommend that. Let's talk yarn. So of course, to knit, you need to have some yarn. So for this project, we're going to be using some bamboo yarn or cotton yarn. So that's what you want to be looking for, bamboo or cotton yarn, or it can also be like a mix of cotton and maybe some bamboo or something else, but definitely not wool or alpaca or anything like that, but some material that you can wash easily. Now, when it comes to yarn, you have different thickness and different fibers and so forth. And rule of thumb is really the thicker the yarn, the bigger the needles you need. And the way you find out what the recommendation is for a certain type of yarn is that when you buy a ball of yarn, there is always this little banner with some information. And here it usually says what type of needle, what size needle is recommended for that yarn. Beware though, there isn't really any right or wrong, and because every knitter's tension, so when you knit, so how tense it becomes, is a little different. So that's just something that you will learn over time and you'll feel it out. But when you really don't know, you can use that as a recommendation. So for this project, I'm going to be using this cotton yarn. And for this project, I'm going to be using 6 millimeter needles.
Another thing you're going to need is a tapestry needle, and then optional is a crochet hook. Step number one is to cast on, so I'm going to teach you how to cast on. So grab your yarn and leave a tail of about 20 centimeters. Then make a loop and thread the yarn through the loop to create a slip knot. Then grab your needle and thread your needle through the hoop and tighten the slip knot. Grab the yarn with your left hand and then with your thumb thread it underneath your yarn to form a sort of crisscross, and then take your right needle, pull that through to form a loop. So this first loop is a stitch, so you have now cast on 2 stitches. Grab your yarn, take your thumb, and then again thread your right needle through, and then you let go to make that hoop. So now that is your 3rd stitch. So every loop represents 1 stitch, and we are going to be casting on 30 stitches, so 30 loops altogether for this dishcloth project. So just continue along the way. And one thing to be mindful is that you don't make it too tight, because that will make it very difficult to start this project. So just make sure that you're not making your loops too tight. After you've cast on 30 stitches, just go ahead and take your needle from your right hand to your left hand, and at the same time also turn it around. Now we are going to knit your first row. So grab your other needle and thread it through that first loop. Wrap some yarn around it and take your right needle out the same way you came in through that loop and let go of all of it onto your right needle. So you are now knitting. This is how you do a simple knit stitch. So you just go through every loop, you wrap around some yarn, you go out the same way you came in, and then you take all of that and just let go of it so it transfers to your right needle. and then you just continue for 30 more stitches. In through the loop, wrap around the yarn, out again, and then you let go of it so it transfers from the left needle to the right needle. And as you can see, I'm holding the needles in a very particular way. In the beginning, this might be all too complicated and you might have to do it very step by step. That's totally fine. You will get the hang of it when you do it a bit more. And again, this first row might feel very tight and it's will be much easier after the first row, I can promise you. So you might have to fiddle around a little bit and try to make your stitches even out, but the first row is always a little bit of a pain and then it gets so much smoother. Now you've knitted your first row, then you're again just gonna take your right hand needle, place it in your left hand, and then you want to make sure that you're knitting with the yarn that goes through your ball of yarn, so not the short little one. And then you're just gonna continue along the same way. So just knitting. And when you knit each row, so every time you finish one row, that is called a row, pretty simply. And when you knit each row like we do now, this is called garter stitch. So when every row is knitted, it is called garter stitch. Now, one tip actually, because we are going to just knit a flat square and we want to have the edges be a little neater. And one little tip is to actually to not knit the first stitch, but just slip that onto your right needle. So without actually knitting it. So that will just create a little bit of a nicer edge to your dishcloth. For this pattern, you can see I made some stripes and I'm going to teach you how to make these stripes. It is super, super easy. So after you've knitted six rows with your first color, we are going to change color. And this is super simple. The only way you really do this is you grab your second color. Again, you leave about 20 centimeters of a tail and you simply switch to this yarn. So you just start to knit with this second color, exactly the same way you would with your main color. Now you're just switching the color and then you're just going to leave some of that yarn and then we're just going to weave in those ends in the end. So you don't have to worry about them yet. Just make sure that it's not too loose. And some people put a little knot here. I don't usually do that. I just make sure that they're a little bit tight and then I just start knitting away. And then I made two rows of the secondary color. Then I again had four rows of my main color, so the pink color here, then two rows of this white color, and then I continued with a pretty big chunk of that rose color, and then two rows white, four rows pink, two rows white, and six rows of pink. Obviously, this is totally optional. You could just make a unicolored square as your first project, but just adding some color is a super easy way to make it fun. And again, as you can see, it's really simple to do. I made my dishcloth approximately 25 centimeters long, but you can really make it as long as you want. But I stopped at around 25 centimeters. And now we can't just take this off the needles because then it will unravel. So we have to cast off. So I'm going to show you how to cast off. Again, very simple. So again, you just start as you would normally do. So you're going to first knit two stitches exactly as you would normally do. Then using your left needle, you're going to go in through that first stitch and place your right hand index finger on the second stitch while with the left needle, you drag the first stitch over. So you are essentially dragging the first stitch over the second stitch. So let's do that once more. So again, you knit, so you have two stitches on your right hand needle, and then with the left needle, you go in through the first stitch and you drag it over like this. And then you just let go of all of that. So you only have one stitch left. And this is how you cast off. And again, make sure to keep the tension so it's even and you don't tighten it too much because then you will have a very tight edge and we don't want that. So just go across the entire row and cast off. So in a way, you're actually decreasing stitches here. And make sure that you have a nice edge that is not too tight but not too loose either. And again, this is something that when you knit more, you'll get that tension that is more even. It always takes a little bit of practice. And then you just go through all across, and this is how it should look. When you've cast off all of your 30 stitches and then you come to that last stitch, again, drag that first one over the second one. And if you just want to finish here, you can just cut this off and just drag it through. But you could also make a little loop, and I'm going to show you how you can crochet a little loop just using a simple crochet hook. And I had a crochet hook number 3.5 millimeters. So just go insert your crochet hook into that loop that was left. And just by doing a simple slip stitch, or I believe this is called chain stitch in crochet language. So just make around 9 or 10 chain stitches. And then once you're happy with the size of your loop, you just go attach them to that beginning again. And then you're going to weave in that end. Now you can cut the yarn off and then just pull it through, and then grab your tapestry needle to weave in this end, because we don't, again, want to unravel this, and we want to make sure that this is really secure so it doesn't come unraveling when it hangs on a hook somewhere. So thread that yarn on your tapestry needle, and there are so many different ways and schools on how you're supposed to weave in ends. I think everybody has their own preferences, but it is important always to weave in your yarns on the wrong side. But of course, this is reversible, so we don't really have a right side and a wrong side. So I just duplicated some of the stitches and tried to make it very invisible. And also, you usually want to go in two directions, so first maybe vertically and then change direction. And also, sometimes what I like to do is that I have a sharp tapestry needle so I can go through the yarn. So this is cotton yarn, so you can actually sort of break the yarn, and that will just give a little bit more friction to make sure that this thread doesn't come unraveling. And once you feel like it's secure, you can just go ahead and cut that yarn. If you made the stripes, we have to weave in those ends as well. So again, just use your tapestry needle and try to make it as invisible as possible. It will get a little bit thicker where you've woven in your ends, but usually it's not that visible. And it's honestly, if it's not perfect or you can see a little bit that it's handmade, I think that's just part of the charm of making something by hand. And there you have it. You have now made a nice handmade dishcloth, your first knit project, or maybe this isn't your first project, but if it's your first project, then congratulations. So well done.
Thank you so much for joining me in this knit challenge. I hope you enjoyed this first project, and I hope you're gonna now spend the evening knitting, maybe watching some Netflix. And then if you create something, I'd love to see it. So then remember to use the hashtag knitwithkika for any projects really, or if you decide to make this one on Instagram or here on YouTube. And I will see you back here next week with another knit project. It's gonna be a small one as well, but a really, really nice one. And I'm going to teach you how to purl stitch so that you can make stockinette stitch, which is the most commonly used knit stitch. So that is gonna be exciting. All right, take care and see you next week. Bye.
There's a bee in my bonnet, hello, hello, a bee in my bonnet, hello. There's a bee in my bonnet, hello, hello, a bee in my bonnet, hello.